Hey guys, what's up? Today is Sunday, May 5th, 2013. Today is actually my mother's birthday. So what's up? What happened today? What happened? Think through, flashback. I woke up today. It's actually another really. Hold on, focus. Can't really tell as much right now because a little bit later, but it's very another gorgeous. My favorite word, day out today, and it's one of those days where there aren't like, I haven't seen even one cloud in the sky, which is always nice, so today we went to this sort of like, we call it like the bike path. It's kind of just like road trail kind of near my school where you just go walk and stuff, and went there, and then we came home. I rode my bike a lot today. I'm going to start posting my videos back up on Blip again, blip.tv. I don't really know why. I just kind of like, one reason I like, how there you can like put custom thumbnails, and I still kind of miss that from having partnership features, so that's cool. And yeah, so, that's really no real change for my YouTube channel. Same thing as normal, but, I think like for my YouTube videos now, I post on Blip. On the first line in the description is a link to the same video on Blip TV. What else happened? I watched the replay of the Kentucky Derby a few times. Still pretty proud of myself. Called Orb. And for the Preakness, 2 weeks from yesterday, I am still going for Orb. I knew that whoever won the Derby, I would be going for in the Preakness, even if it wasn't Orb, because I want to see Triple Crown winner. That'd be cool. And so, if Orb runs in the Preakness, which his status is probable, like, probably will, and, yeah, hopefully he wins that. The Preakness is a little short of a race. The Derby was a mile and a fourth, and the Preakness is, I think, just under a mile. I think it's like 11/18, or I'm not sure about, I'm not positive, but it's, I think, just under a mile, and I think that's not exactly the best thing for Orb, considering he's sort of a come-from-behind horse. He did amazing in the Derby, how he was in 15th place going to the final turn, and just the length of the turn, he got up to the lead and won it by the end in the last furlong. And that strategy won't be as good for a shorter race, considering he won't have as much time to get to the front if he starts off behind, so he'll probably have to start with a new strategy by going to the front, or at least closer to the leaders, because he, at the beginning of the Derby, he got off to a good start, but kind of got boxed out by horses that were in front of him, and then set back, and then, like I said, you know, by the first turn, he was almost in dead last, and then by the final turn, he was still only in 15th place out of 19 horses, but in the end, he won it, which is awesome, and yes, so he'll have to have a different strategy for the Preakness. And for the Belmont, he would probably go the same strategy he does now with coming from behind, because the Belmont is a mile and a half, which is a very long race for horses. The average time is like roughly 2 minutes 30 seconds. Secretariat has the world record still from 1973 of 2 minutes 24 seconds. And yeah, a record that from 40 years ago, from June 9th, is the 40-year anniversary of when Secretariat set that record, and still has not been ever come close to, and I don't expect it really ever will. But anyways, what else? I think that's all. I have a history test tomorrow. This one, in particular, I'm relatively confident about. I just finished my assignments. I had to write, like, 4 different paragraphs about Native Americans and stuff, and we're doing a unit on that now. And the test tomorrow is we pick, like, Native American tribe and just write, like, a paragraph about their story from when the, like, whites first showed up in America towards how they ended up, like, where they are today as part of our test. And then another part is the map test, where we just have to list, like, different trails and reservations and forts and battles and stuff, and I still have to study for the map test, but other than that, I'm pretty much ready, and yeah, that's cool. And I do my first horse riding lesson on Saturday, May 11th still, and yes, I'm excited for that, and yeah, I think that's all I have to say for now. Yeah, so anyways, thanks for watching. Make sure to click like button below if you liked it. Subscribe to both my channels for more. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.